हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम उमेश वोरा फ्रॉम पी चंद्रा इंटरनेशनल स्कूल बुरसर, क्लास 11 फिजिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर 2, यूनिट एंड मेजरमेंट। इन द टुडेज टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एरर। ओके, कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एरर। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द रैंडम एरर्स, टाइप्स ऑफ एरर, सिस्टमेटिक एरर एंड द रैंडम एरर्स। And now today we are discussing about that the combination of error. Combination of error. Okay. If we do an experimental involving the several measurement, we must know how the errors in all the measurement combine. For example, mass density is obtained by dividing mass by the volume of the substance. If we have errors in the measurement of mass and of the size or dimension, we must know what the error will be in density of the substance. To make such estimate, we should learn how the error combine. Okay, how the error combine in various mathematical operations. For this, we use the following procedures. Just a second. Okay, there are the three. First of all, in the combination of error, we have three main important things. Is that first one is that the error of a sum or a difference. Okay, error of a sum or a difference. Second one is that error of a product or a quotient, and the third one is that the error in case of measure quantity rise to a power. So in this topic today we have discussing about that the error of a sum or a difference. So suppose we have two physical quantity, one is A and the second is B, have measure value A plus or minus delta A, B plus or minus delta B respectively. Okay, we have the measure value is quantity is suppose. So suppose two physical quantities A and the B have measure value A plus delta A and the B plus delta B respectively, where delta A and the delta B are the absolute errors. Okay, we have already discussed in the previous topic and what is the absolute error. So delta A and the delta B are the absolute error. We wish to find the error delta Z in the sum. Delta Z in the sum is Z is equals to A plus B. Okay, so it is the result A plus B, and we have by addition Z plus delta Z. Then A plus or minus delta A plus B plus or minus delta B. We have the two quantities A plus or minus delta A and the B plus or minus delta B respectively. The maximum possible error in a Z, okay, is that delta Z is equals to delta A plus delta B. A plus or minus delta A plus B plus or minus delta B. The maximum possible error in a Z is that delta Z is equals to delta A plus or plus delta B. Suppose we have taking the difference, okay, between these two quantities is Z is equals to A minus B. We get that Z plus or minus delta Z is equals to A plus or minus delta A minus B plus minus delta B. So this is the addition and also this is the difference. So it will give us the A minus B is equals to A minus B plus or minus delta A plus or minus delta B. It will give us to the error.
The see here delta z, here our delta z absolute error in the in sum of the absolute error or the difference of the absolute error delta z is equals to, here we will get that plus or minus delta a or plus or minus delta b. Either we are getting addition or either we are getting the subtraction, we will get the absolute error in the summation of absolute error or the difference in the absolute error. The maximum value of the error delta z is again delta a plus delta b. Hence the rule, when two quantities, this is our rule, when the two quantities are add, subtract, the absolute error in the final result is the sum of absolute error in the individual quantities. I repeat, when two quantities are added or subtract, the absolute error in the final result is the sum of absolute errors in the individual quantities. So this is our the first thing is that, what is that error of sum or a difference. Now our second topic is that error of a product or a quotient. Okay, error of product of quotient. So we have, suppose in the error of product or quotient, here we have shown that the z is equals to a into b, and then the measure value of a here and b are the a into delta a, b are the a and the b are a here a is equals to a plus or minus delta and the b is equals to plus or minus delta b. Then the product of these things, z is equals to z plus or minus delta a is equals to, here we have a plus or minus delta a and the b is equals to plus or minus delta b. Now similarly, whenever we are doing that the simple multiplication in the polynomials, like here we have doing that the a multiply by this, a multiply by b, here a multiply by b, then after a also multiply by delta b. Okay, then after, so we get the a into b is equals to ab. Then after a multiply ab, then after a multiply by delta ab is equals to, here we have got the a into delta b. Similarly, this is multiply delta a multiply by delta b, and also this delta a multiply with the delta b. So you will get the a into b. So here a into b, then after delta a into b, okay, a into b, then after delta a into b, b into delta a, then after you have multiplying with this product into these things. This will gives you a into delta b. So here, and also these things are multiply with the delta b, so you will get delta a into delta b. Okay, so dividing by LHS by z, okay, here divide here in these things, dividing by the z and the right hand side by AB. So this equation is dividing by the AB. This AB will divide by this AB. So you will be get the z divided by z is equals to here 1, z divided by z is equals to 1 plus and the delta plus or minus delta z by, here we have delta z by z here is equals to against here AB divided by the AB, so it will also gives us to A. here delta A B into delta A divided by the A B. So B will be remains cut. Then after it will give us delta A by A plus or minus whatever A delta A B divided by A B. Here A will be cut out. So it will give us delta B by B plus or minus delta A into delta B. Here anything is not cut out, so delta A by A and the delta B by B. But this, the product, the smallest value error, absolute error product is very small, so we will neglect this thing. This term will be neglected in this equation. So we have just now we have just A plus or minus delta Z by Z is equals to A plus or 1 here A 1 plus or minus delta Z by Z is equals to 1 plus or minus delta A by A plus or minus delta B by B. So here also 1 both the side. So we have this one and also this one will be neglected. So we have delta Z by Z is equals to delta A by A plus or minus delta B by B. So delta A and delta B are small. We have small, ignore that, I already told you. Hence the maximum relative error is equals to delta Z by Z is equals to delta A by A plus delta B by B. You can easily verify that this is the true for the division also. Okay, so it is same for the division also. So hence the rule, when the two quantities are multiply or divide, the relative error in the result is the sum of the relative error in the multipliers. Okay, when the two quantities are multiply or divide, the relative error in the result is the sum of the relative error in the multipliers. Okay, and also now our third topic is that see here, error in case of measure quantity rise to a power. Okay, in the case of measure quantity rise to a power. Here suppose we have a z is equals to a square. Okay, here we have z is equals to a square. So when the a square is, z is equals to a square, all the time we will explain these terms. Then delta Z here, so delta Z by Z is equal to, we have shown that the A square is equals to, z is equals to a square. Suppose a square. Okay, so here a is the two time. So delta Z by Z, it is a one type of product. So we need to require delta. It is the in the previous point we have shown that the product, whenever the product, we need to sum of the its absolute error by two quantities. So here delta A by A plus delta A by A, so it will gives us to 2 × 2 = delta A by A. Hence the relative error in a square is 2 times the error in a. In general, if z is equals to a raised to p, b raised to q, and the c raised to so we get that the z does z by z. Suppose we have a square, so here 2, so we have a p, a is to p, so p will be come at the this sides, p will be come at this sides, so p z delta z by z is equals to p into delta a by a, plus here also b have b raised to q, so b also q raised q will be also come at the before this side, so q delta b by b, and the also here c raised to r, so r also this term also will be plus, so r delta c by c. So here shows that the hence the rule is equals to the relative error in a physical quantity rise to the power k is the k time relative. Here so the p power a raised to p power, so k time so p time the relative error in individual quantity. Suppose here we have a k power is k, the k times of the relative error in the individual quantity. Similarly here b raised to q power, so q times the relative error. Also here c raised to r power, so r into delta c by c. Now we have shown that the one example find the relative error in z is equals to z a raised to 4, b raised to 1/3, c raised to 1, d raised to minus d raised to 3/2. So here c raised to nothing will here, so we will take a c raised to 1. So relative error z is equals to delta z by z is equals to c, here 4 is come outside it, 4 delta a by a, plus here 1/3, so 1/3 is come outside, 1/3 delta b by b, plus c raised to 1, so c raised here nothing will be coming here, so delta c by c, plus here d raised to 3/2, so d raised to 3/2 here, put it here 3/2 delta d by d. Okay, this is the example. Now we have another example, the periodic oscillation of a simple pendulum. Now you saw that the pendulum is that it is the suspended by the thread, and it has a mass bob by the any particular fixed point. We are suspended hanging by the thread. So this is known as the pendulum. So the pendulum is the period of oscillation of a simple pendulum is d is equals to 2 pi under root l upon z. The measure value of l is 20 centimeter known to 1 mm accuracy, and the time for the 100 oscillation of a pendulum is found to be 90 second using a wristwatch of 1 second resolution. What is the accuracy in the determination of g? Now here we need to require the g value of g. So g is equals to here t is equals to 2 pi under root l upon g. Here we need to find the g. So we are taking that the square of the both the side t square 2 into 2 will 2 4 pi 4 into pi square l divided by g. So we are the making a mean of the g, so we will get the 4 pi square l by t square. So here the t is equals to t by n and the delta t by n, therefore the delta t by t is equals to delta t by t. The error in both l and t are the least count error. So here t square delta g by g is equals to delta l by l, okay, and the t square, so here we are putting that the 2 into delta t by t. Here we have the l is 20 length, l is the 20 centimeter known to 1 mm accuracy. 1 mm is the error of this thread, and 1.1 by 20. So and the 1 is here, so 1 is the resolution of wristwatch divided by the 90 second. So we get the multiplication 0.1 by 20 plus 2 into 1 by 90, it will give us the 0.2 into 20. So now with us, we need to percentage error in G. Here we end in the previous, we will source that the multiplying by the 100. So it will give us the percentage error in G. It will give us delta L by L multiply by 100 plus 2 into delta L by L. It will give us to 3%. How much error in this measurement? 3% error in this measurement. Our next topic is significant number, significant figure. In the next lecture, we will discuss the significant figure.